Hi guys, welcome to Happiness Per KM. My name is Sumit Berry and I have with me Rajiv Rakshit today. This is the episode number 3 of the series that we call Motoring Tips. And today we are going to talk about caring for the rider and his motorcycle.
So Sumit, since you are a champion of all things lube, why don't you tell us a little bit about caring for your bike when on a long ride?
Okay, Rajiv, I'll start off with the lubes available in the market for the chain. And see, this is called Maxima Chain Wax. This is a new thing which is available in the market. This is not your regular oil-based lube. This is wax. Okay, now the difference is it is dry.
Right.
Okay, when your bike moves after lubing, the excess lube does not, you know, spill on your entire motorcycle or on the rims, because you know it's very difficult to clean the rim afterwards. So chain wax is something which is useful. This is a smaller pack which is good for short tours. You're going in for 2-3 days, you can use the smaller pack.
So Sumit, you just spoke about the lubing part of it, but before lubing a chain you also clean it, right? So is it important to carry it as well with something like this?
You should carry a chain cleaner as well. That also comes in a smaller bottle like this. You can use that.
So, but do you have to carry that big brush and do it like that, or can you just clean
you
it?
You have to carry it. It's not a big brush. It is just this long. You can carry that brush. That's not a problem.
Okay. So what else do you have for us?
So there is another one which is from Puto line. It is called the ceramic chain wax. It is again same thing as that, but it is a bigger bottle.
Right.
This, you should keep this at home. Okay.
So, just for my knowledge, something that seems to be a bestseller is the Motul.
There is Motul also available. This is a bigger bottle. It also comes in small bottle for your tours. You can carry it. And the basic difference between the Tritec and this one is, this is not based on a non-fling formula. This is a non-fling thing. So it is, both of them are good.
Yeah.
They work the same.
So depending upon my budget and my availability, I can go for something slightly cheaper or something slightly more expensive.
Correct.
But both of them are equally good, and you can decide based on your requirement.
Yeah.
So Sumit, I know there are multiple products with multiple cans. Is there something which is like an all-rounder, which might not be the best at everything, but which is a good, very good substitute for all things?
Yes. For that, this is the Liqui Moly multi spray. It is essentially like WD-40, but far better than that.
Right. So you can use it as
A
cleaner, as a lubricator. Correct.
You can use it.
It's a very good product.
Yes, it is.
Very interesting product. So what else do you have for us today?
Okay, I'll talk about the helmet sanitizer.
Something very close to my heart these days.
Yes, you must use it because especially in summer, you sweat a lot, and your liner inside the helmet tends to get a lot of bacteria and tends to get a lot dirty. So helmet sanitizer is a must. I use a 3M one. This is a Puto line. Works the same. It is also alcohol based and it's quite nice.
Excellent product. Wonderful. So this is what we do for the bike and this one for the gear. But in terms of information, there's no replacement for data in today's day and world. Mm-hmm. So for my safety, God forbid, there is a need for other people to know who I am and my medical history. What are the things that you do?
So Rajiv, to start with, God forbid I or you or any rider meets with an accident, one must have this. You can see this. One must have this patch which has got essential information in case of an accident. People can read it and understand what is my blood group. It is mentioned here in case this is of a friend named Ashish Behel, and his blood group is B positive. His number, his emergency number is mentioned here, and his name is there, and the country flag for.
So there's an emergency contact number as well.
Yes, emergency contact.
It's a very good idea.
Yeah. So you must have this on your jacket.
Jacket.
Placed right here. So it is easy, because generally when a rider falls down, people tend to put him on his back on the ground. So this is visible, so people can call the emergency number.
Since Ashish is B positive, why does he always carry a B negative? Is this metaphorical in nature?
No.
We'll leave that topic. Moving forward, what is next?
Okay. So another solution to this is there are stickers available. There is a company called Crisis Code who have come up with these stickers. You can buy these and place them on your helmet. And make sure you always place them on the helmet and not your motorcycle, because your motorcycle may be somebody else may be riding it someday. So this can be a, you know, very fatal. Yeah. And there's another big sticker. This also goes on your helmet. It has got a QR code. A lot of people are quite familiar, even in villages today, with the QR code, because thanks to Paytm and everything, you know, it's something which is not new to people. So you can place it on your helmet.
Your entire medical history.
Yes, you can get your number, everything what this does, the QR code also provides, and some additional information as well.
So
So in case you don't have any of these, the cheapest solution and the basic thing is to have this, you know, printed in the form of a sticker on your helmet. So like you can see the name here, Ashish Behl, and the blood group. And also you can have an emergency contact number here.
And this can be done at any number plate guy.
Yeah, any your neighborhood.
At a very cheap 50 maker. Rupees, yeah. You can get this done.
You can get this done. Yeah.
So, ladies and gentlemen, my one experience and input is, please don't treat this as another sticker. Please use it at a place of prominence, as Sumit said. You might be exchanging bikes on your ride. So, ideal place for something like this is on your body, on one of your gears. But put it in a place of prominence so that it can be easily visible.
Another thing, Rajiv, is the ORS pack.
ORS Ghol.
ORS Ghol, yeah. It might sound funny to many people.
It's a lifesaver.
It is a lifesaver. As you know it, you tend to get dehydrated when you are riding, especially in summer. So this is something which you should keep with you, because you can even find water anywhere and just pour it in the glass and have it. You must have it. Perhaps in your hydration bag also, you can mix it and keep it in your hydration bag.
You read my mind. I was about to say that you can put it in the hydration bag, or I'm sure you carry a bottle of water.
Correct.
Make it pre-mixed, because while you're riding, you'll always keep feel lazy
yes.
to make it again.
Correct.
Keep it ready before you get on the bike and keep sipping.
Absolutely.
And not just in terms of temperatures, but even in terms of altitude changes. There's a lot of nausea and sometimes motion sickness that comes in.
Yeah.
This tends to help.
Absolutely. Next up is the microfiber cloth. It is quite a fancy cloth. I sourced it from a friend. So the yellow side you see here is for your helmet visor, and the gray side is for cleaning your motorcycle. It is washable in soft water, quite handy, available on Amazon.com. The brand name is, this is called Popo microfiber cloth. So you can read in the description about the brand name and where it is available. And it's quite a nice thing to have.
So again, I'd like to reiterate, as we always do, we have showcased a lot of products and brand before we move on. This is our experience. This is what we do. This is what we have learned. This is in no circumstances a recommendation of anything. From our experience, if you can learn something, if it can help you, as per your budget, please make the sanest and safest decision.
So we are talking about cleaning the motorcycle, microfiber cloth and all. So this is a revolutionary product which is called Vulcan Wipes. You know, this is quite eco-friendly. You can use one of this, one wipe, okay, and you can clean your entire motorcycle with this.
Right.
Just clean it and then use the microfiber cloth to do it. It just takes about 10 minutes to clean your motorcycle with this.
Yeah, makes sense.
It's you can clean your helmet visor as well with this.
Yeah, right. Makes sense. You save water, you don't have to carry pieces of cloth, and it's easy to dispose, environmentally friendly.
Yes.
Makes tremendous sense.
And
is there a smaller pack of this while I'm traveling?
Yeah, it is available. The cap of this pack is quite nice. You can keep a microfiber cloth here.
I have a question that suddenly popped in my head.
Yeah.
How long? This is obviously a special, you know, product which is almost like a wet wipe kind of thing.
Yeah.
And this is a fairly large container. How long do these last?
So Rajiv, I have been using this for over a year now. The only thing you need to be careful about is storage.
Correct.
How do you store it? Because if it gets dry, then the entire purpose of using these wipes is gone. So this is a basic hack that I use. I open the cap, place this polythene here, and
so sort of vacuum seal it.
Correct.
Quick fix.
Vacuum seal.
Yeah, makes sense.
Stays dry and lasts you longer.
So that's about the, you know, the caring of the bike.
Yeah.
But there will be unforeseen circumstances where you might need to repair something small.
Correct.
Like a puncture or something else on your bike. So instead of carrying something, you know, bulky or substantial, what would you recommend?
You can carry a small toolkit. You know, the toolkit that comes with the motorcycle is not sufficient.
Yeah.
You can carry this. It has got a set of Allen keys.
Oh wow.
Got some screws.
This is very small and very light.
Yeah.
Very light.
And very easy to carry as well.
Yeah, you can just slip it in, you know, one of the side pockets with easy access. And not heavy at all.
Yeah.
How much does something like this cost?
Okay, Rajiv, there are different packs available in the market, different brands. So somewhere around 2 to 5,000 rupees you can spend and keep on.
This is money very well invested, I think.
Yeah, absolutely. It's a lifesaver.
And so, since you have a tubeless motorcycle, I would presume you have a puncture kit as well.
Correct.
That you carry?
Yes, I use a puncture kit, which is right here.
It's got a lot of things.
Yep.
It's got a
plier
as well.
Yeah.
And a cutter and yep. stuff like that. Very nice.
Glue.
So my experience, yep. I have bought kits before where I've got just, you know, one of these and some of these. But if you buy and invest in something like this, it's all together. You've got pretty much even the nitty gritties that you need that normal kits don't provide. It's extremely good value for money and can save a lot of unpleasantness and a lot of time for you.
And this costs about 600 to 800 rupees.
Excellent.
Rajiv, there's one more thing I want to show you, though I'm sure you must be keeping it. A lot of people keep it, but you know, in case anybody forgets. This is a USB cable for charging your phone, and it has got multi heads in front of it. You can charge an iPhone or a phone with a micro USB or a USB-C. So it has got everything.
No, this is a tremendous use because on the go, I charge my phone on something like this. I charge my Bluetooth headset on something like this. You can charge cameras,
Absolutely.
Some of the cameras on this. Extremely useful in your, you know, travel plans.
Absolutely. And you should make sure it has got some amount of metal woven with it.
Correct.
On the cover so
Correct.
That, you know, it doesn't wear out.
Easily.
Yeah.
Yeah, makes sense. So that's pretty much a wrap. The last thing, but not the least, very important, is a first aid kit.
Absolutely.
So what do you carry and what should Absolutely. People plan for?
Yeah, absolutely. I carry this kind of a pouch, and I keep Savlon, Sofromycin,
Band-Aids,
and your cotton, Band-Aids. You know, all those things in this.
Something for sickness,
Absolutely.
Motion sickness,
yeah,
something for slight fever, paracetamol or something.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So that's a small medical pouch that I keep with me.
Wonderful.
Guys, thank you very much for watching the video. I hope you liked the episode number 3 of Motoring Tips by Happiness Per KM. In case you want us to cover more such things in our next videos, kindly write in to me at sumit@happinessperkm.com. Do not forget to click like, share and subscribe to our YouTube channel called Happiness Per KM. Thank you for watching.